Great to have you with us at Radoga near Krasnoyarsk. It's hard to believe that 2.5 hours ago it was snowing here. The clouds have been blown away. A little bit of a breeze has sprung up, and we are under bright blue skies and ready for another great race. It's the men's 4x7.5k relay. Not quite as simple as it sounds, because some of the race is skied in classic style and some in freestyle, as the athletes make their way out to the start area. Different conditions today. We've already heard some comments after the women's race that the snow this morning caught them a little bit on the hop, and they had to do a quick adjustment to the ski wax composition. It was well adjusted indeed for the Russian Federation, which came through again in the women's event. And it would surprise if the men didn't back up the women's effort. They've got a team bristling with medalists and quick skiers. So the wind has picked up, that's for sure. 4.2 meters per second now from the west. It's not cold though, -3. Snow temperature a steady -6 as it's been throughout the week. Russia, Kazakhstan, Japan, Belarus, Germany, Switzerland, Poland, Norway. Japan figured prominently in the women's event, finishing second. Finland at the bottom of the screen there might be competitive today. It is the men's 4x7.5k relay. Starting off the first two competitors for each team in classic style as they hustle out of the stadium. Brilliant sunshine, a little bit of wind on the course, and the only concern would be around the trickier, quicker sections that a sudden gust of wind could cause a balance issue. Not really expecting that to happen, but it certainly is windier than a couple of hours ago. So up one of the steeper sections, and it is Kirillov who wants to lead them through. And that's followed then by Ivan Luft from Kazakhstan in two. Team seven is Poland, and their lead skier is Matusz Haratyk. Back of the field there in 11 at the moment, the Republic of Korea, Byung Ji Young. So Finland, the Russian Federation, Kazakhstan and Japan. Kirov, Luft, Makala and Uda come through. Only a couple of seconds between them. Then there's a little bit of a gap back. Let's just check out what that is. With Japan 2 seconds behind the Russian Federation. Into the stadium for the first time. These skiers have another lap to do. Kirillov. And then he's followed by Ivan Luft. And then Makala. And then a couple of seconds back to Uda, who is doing his very best to hold on here. And he's doing that. He's sort of attached himself to the back of the group again. He was in danger of losing touch. Standing out quite proudly, aren't they, the flags? In the breeze today from the west. A little bit of a move made by Ivan Luft just to see what Kirillov has got. I don't think the Russian team will be too worried by a bit of a sprint coming from Luft. As we head in for the first of the changeovers. And Luft will hand over to Aset Dyasanov. Kirillov The job will be taken up by Anton Timashov. Great first leg, skied by Kazakhstan's Ivan Lyuft. And the first two teams are out on the second leg. Russian Federation through Timashov have just eased past Kazakhstan. And Yusinov settles in behind him. Just a little touch on the stock of the lead skier, that's fine, just to let him know that you're there, and also stop yourself being impaled. Through the woods they'll come. It's a fairly prominent murmur of the wind through the trees as Timashov can't quite shake off Dyusinov. Perhaps the crucial leg will be the third. You know, Klivniuk will ski for the Russian Federation. He was a sixth place finisher in the 10K, but his opponent in the next leg, Nikita Gridin, he was 27th, so there's a big difference there. Both Lyuft and Dyusinov skiing first and second for Kazakhstan in this relay, they were top 10. So you'd expect them to be able to, for half the race, run with the highly fancied Russian Federation. And that's what's happening. So Timashov just can't quite shake off Dyusinov. Russian fans getting excited about this next changeover. But there's nothing in it between Russia and Kazakhstan. Only 1.2 seconds. So great legs skied by Dyusinov and Timashov. The move from the Russian Federation just feels like it's inevitable. When will it come? Will it be from the local man from Krasnoyarsk, Kirill Klivniuk? Can he be the one to shake off Kazakhstan, who are represented on this third leg by Nikita Gridin? Can't quite shake him off yet. Klivniuk, early stages of the third leg. That's Klivniuk and Gridin. Settle into the rhythm of their own little race. Their own 7.5 kilometres. They're skiing freestyle, of course, now, which I'm sure you would have noticed. Legs 3 and 4, freestyle. There is the story at the second changeover. Still Russia and Kazakhstan locked together. Finland racing their own race, a minute 17 behind, but as much again ahead of Poland. Up front though, it is Klivniuk and Gridin. This battle doesn't look like it's changing anytime soon, but it can happen at a moment's notice. Klivniuk doesn't have to give notice. He can just set off if he's got it in him. Gridin is doing a great job of sticking with him. Just a tiny gap there, maybe a little tester from Klivniuk to see if Gridin could go with him. So they're in the stadium now, and there is a gap. Klivniuk over Gridin. We know the Russian skis are wonderfully prepared. Their wax technicians have got them skiing at their absolute best and quickest. And I think that Nikita Gridin might be starting to hurt a little. This pace is sorting him out. As Kilivniuk looks to establish a lead. What better place to do it than in front of your fans in the arena as they come through and then set off once more. 2 seconds isn't much, but if it keeps building, then it is significant. We'll check them again soon. 2.1 seconds. Kilivniuk and Gridin. Okay, here is the gap. Yes, the move has been made. We thought it would be. Kirill Kilivniuk has left Gridin somewhere behind. Gridin coming through as Kirill Kilivniuk is fulfilling the requirements of the team here. The coaches will be very pleased that he's opened up this gap, make them all feel a little more comfortable. Kilivniuk. Oh, he's got quite a gap now. Not surprised, really. Gridin doesn't have the pace of his Russian opponent. Just a little surprised that it's so big a margin so quickly. Nikita Gridin. Is a minute behind now. And so for so much of the race, they were within a second or so and even led it briefly when Liuft decided to take it ahead of the Russian Federation. So Kilivniuk makes the changeover to Ivan Yakimushkin, one of the stars of the games, the gold medal in the 10K Classic and in the 10K Pursuit on the opening 2 days of competition. He was ever so close to a third gold medal in the sprint, had it taken away from him by the jury, who didn't like the clash he had with Terentyev. And there's the touch on Klimin. And on he goes. So the third changeover happening with 56 minutes and 23 seconds for Russia. Exhausted. Away from the noise of the public address and fans, the sound of the wind coming through the woods a bit more noticeable. And as he skates around the descent, no problems there for Ivan Yakimushkin. Looking to put the finishing touches to another gold medal effort. So Russia with 7 gold medals out of 8 events so far. This would be 8 from 9. We've got 5 teams that have won 1 medal, including the Czech Republic with 1 gold. But the Russian Federation has 19 medals. The one currently held by 5 other nations. But there's a chance here for Kazakhstan and Finland to add to their little tally. Yakimushkin He was a little unlucky to miss out on his hat-trick of gold medals. The sprint finish was quite controversial. Yakimushkin bolts into the stadium for the first time, and that's got the crowd in good voice. So Yakimushkin had this clash of stocks with Terentyev at the end of the sprint, and it looked like he was just kind of annoyed by what happened, and he wasn't sure whether he's pulling on his stock or Terentyev's, it seemed to many of us. But he gave it a bit of a hard pull, and that was enough to sway the minds of the jury that he'd done something he really shouldn't have, and he was disqualified, having crossed the line first. So he was denied a third gold medal, but the way he's skiing now, that third gold is only a few minutes away. Yakimushkin's lead. Let's check it out as the clock continues ticking. As Olzhas Klimin makes his way around, likes his spot of fishing. Wonder if he does that ice fishing, cut a hole in the ice and drop a line down and see what comes up. Well, they're standing by with the flag, the leading skiers for the Russian Federation. They know what's going to happen here. It's a familiar drill for them, really, as Ivan Kirillov, Anton Timoshov and Kirill Kilyuvnyuk wait for Yakimushkin to finish the job that they started. Nice shot through the trees of our leader, Ivan Yakimushkin. No sign of flagging or lack of concentration. Hours and hours of training often spent on their own, perhaps more often with teammates, but they train to ski on their own and ski at their best possible pace, because that's often going to happen in a race. Yakimushkin, a massive lead. They're under no threat whatsoever. So they brought to this race not just Yakimushkin, who was a double gold medalist in the 10K Classic and Pursuit, but the silver and bronze medalists as well in Timoshov and Kirillov respectively. And then they had six skiers available in those earlier races, and Kilyuvnyuk, who skied the third leg, he was sixth, but ahead of any other athlete from another country in the 10K Classic. So Russia filled the top six places in both the 10K Classic and Pursuit. So here we are, getting towards the end of the men's relay as he comes into the stadium, Ivan Yakimushkin, to confirm what would be the Russian Federation's eighth gold medal and his third. He can really enjoy this moment as he sweeps around to be greeted by an overjoyed local crowd. And his teammates Kirillov, Timoshov and Kilyuvnyuk waiting for him. They're moving towards the finish line now. They've got the Russian flag ready, and as Yakimushkin picks up one of his own to take to the line in convincing style on a glorious day at Radiga, the Russian Federation wins again, this time the 4x7.5K relay. In 1 hour, 15 minutes and 22 seconds, that time a couple of minutes slower than 2 years ago, but on a different course, in different conditions and different skiers. The time doesn't really matter. It's the placing that is the issue. Kazakhstan's Olzhas Klimin has made his way into the stadium too now, and it'll be another silver medal for Kazakhstan. Had an individual silver to Aset Dyusinov in the sprint. You can't miss those Kazakhstan suits. They are some kind of gold. But it won't be gold today for Kazakhstan. It will be silver. No urgency about it for Olzas Klemin. No one's right behind him. He can enjoy this moment, as will his teammates Ivan Liuft, Aset Dyusinov and Nikita Gridin, as Olzas Klemin comes across the line. Second place for Kazakhstan. We also have the Finns coming in. Great last leg from Joel Ikonen to wrap up the bronze medal for Finland, and for Michaela Sarkkinen and Vinkanu. A bit of excitement as well as they claim third. When last we saw them, Japan was sitting alone in fourth. A lot of handshaking going on in the finish area. I'm always pleased to see that the sport and the event is conducted in a good spirit. And that's certainly been the case here at the Universiade Games. FISU can be proud of the way its athletes have conducted themselves. And fourth across the line is indeed Japan, as we expected. 2 minutes 52 behind the win. We'll go to the Russian Federation. Kazakhstan looking forward to their silver medals, and Finland the bronze. Japan fourth in as many Universiade Games at this event. And Germany just holding off Poland for fifth, sixth, and France and Switzerland. Belarus got across the line in ninth position, followed by Austria, Republic of Korea, Norway, Canada, United States, and China. So that is the closing picture really for us at Rudiger today. Two exciting races, the Russian Federation prevailing with their strong teams in the relays. Kazakhstan and Finland present on the podium in the men's. So a good day's racing.